It should be clear now that the first question to consider in terms of botnet CNC design is how can the bots contact their masters safely? In other words, in a stealthy and robust way. And as we have just discussed, a naive approach is not adequate. For example, if we have hard-coded the malware to include a single IP address of our command control server, then when this IP address has been identified by security admins, the network admins, such as admins in the ISP, can block all traffic to this server. Therefore, no command control traffic from the bots can be reached to the botmaster server. And as a result, the whole botnet is disrupted. For example, if all the bots contact a single IP address that's hard-coded in the bot malware, then when this IP address is identified by security admins, the network admins, for example, those at ISP, can block all traffic to this IP, therefore blocking all command control traffic and disrupting the operations of the botnet. And because such naive approach is not stealthy nor robust, it is only used by script kiddies and first-time malware authors. In addition to safety, utility is also very important to the botmaster. In other words, a botmaster wants efficient and reliable communications so that he can reach and coordinate enough bots to perform a specific task. So to summarize the design considerations of botnet CNC, the botmaster would want efficient and reliable communication, that is, the ability to reach to a sizable set of bots within a certain time limit. Stealthy communication so that it is hard to detect CNC traffic. Resilient or robust communication so that it is very hard to disable or block CNC traffic.